Christmas spirit and all the festivities of God being with us. God is with us. Understand all the nations. A bit more than a month ago, we proclaimed that truth both throughout the Christmas season and especially at Epiphany. But today, church is taking us on a different pilgrimage. And in a sense, the Gospel of Prodigal Son is probably one of the best known Gospels, both for us and even for those beyond the Christianity. Perhaps this Gospel and the Gospel of Solar are the few that resonate with almost everyone. And there is definitely a lot of points to meditate upon the Gospel of Saint Matthew, where he describes the life of his prodigal son. But I would like to take you today perhaps on a little bit different and use this Gospel as a sign and help for us to prepare for the Great Lent. Because indeed, if you look at the few Sundays we just had, each of them is in a sense giving us equipment to start this Lenten pilgrimage. First of all, on the Sunday of Zacchaeus, we had that sign of a man. A man of important stature, that's his gospel. A man well recognized in his community and society, who knowing about Christ passing by, is not afraid to climb on a tree to see Jesus. And what is happening at that moment is changing the life of Zacchaeus. Because Christ passing by that place is looking at Zacchaeus and saying, Zacchaeus, today I would like to be with you. Not when you are ready. Not when you probably do all the cleaning of the house and prepare all the festivities. But today, I wish you could. But that encounter with Christ would not happen if Zacchaeus would not have that desire to see Christ himself. Zacchaeus made the first step of going and searching for the Lord. And it's the same with us. 2 weeks from now, basically, or 15 days, we will enter into the Great Lent. And the time of February, probably the snowy season in April, will be over soon. And the Easter. And it will be either another Easter season with families, friends, a beautiful celebration in the church. But even this will pass. But if we all have a desire as a case to take that step, to search for Christ, to meet Him the way we are, He didn't ask Zacchaeus to change that moment. But if you recall that the encounter, Zacchaeus himself, the moment that Christ asked him to come down, said, Lord, I'm willing to repay four times full of every wrong I did. Let me be a better person. Let me be a good example. Week ago, we met another example of how to prepare for that Lenten pilgrimage. Of two men entering into the temple. Pharisee and Publican. And if we will look at the life of Pharisee, we will today call him a good parishioner. Because indeed, in that gospel, Pharisee, first of all, is not are the source of those blessings. But then we know that Christ in this parable is telling us that not Pharisee, but that man publican who was standing by the entrance to the temple was justified in the eyes of Christ. Why? Because he had a humility to stand in front of the face of God in his temple and say, Lord, be merciful to me, a sinner. We ought to seek Christ, and we ought to be faithful and honest with him. Open our heart, be able to ask him to pour in our lives the goodness, the joy, and take us on the pilgrimage of knowing each other. Open the doors of repentance to the Lord Christ. We sing you. And finally today, in the Gospel of Prodigal Son, the church reminds us that we always have a chance of returning to God. Whatever happened in our lives, whatever ways we were either this year or throughout our entire life going in directions different probably from the house of the Almighty God, the Father is saying, come back. And perhaps we are not seeing ourselves as those prodigal son. It will be hard to find too many of them probably today. But definitely each and every one of us can see a little bit of ourselves in the other son, the one who was faithful and always present with his Father, but deeply inside, perhaps desiring to be like the prodigal son and feeling that injustice was done. And God is saying to him and to everyone of us, what is mine is yours. Those small Sundays or messages of those Sundays in preparation for Lent are giving us armor to take the Lenten pilgrimage, to seek God, to be honest with him, and also knowing that he always is ready to welcome us. I pray that the next few weeks there was another feast in between, namely Valentine, which we probably celebrated yesterday or today. But those Sundays are giving us a strength and ability to walk with Christ throughout this entire Lent. And I hope and I pray that those next 40 days of Lenten pilgrimage will be a chance for you to discover God's love, God's presence in your life, and especially his ability to change each and every one of us. Glory to Jesus Christ.
Glory to God.
Slava Jesus.